I pride myself for nothing. Agitated illusion, only built for confusion. The institution, modern day execution. Think I knew the solution, maybe not should I do it. Just put it in the music, just put it in the music.
Someone put me out cause I'm on fire. I can't give a fuck about what they say. They've been searching for that thing to get them higher. You can't catch my drift, can't catch my wave. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing through your veins? Though you may get out as you desire. Those feelings that never be the same. You'll burn out if you jump into the fire. Can you feel it rushing through your right through your veins? Though you may get out as you desire.
This building holds just north of 80,000, and they have come out in very good numbers today at FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport. As both teams made their way out of the tunnel, these folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Washington Football Team. Getting toward the halfway point of the NFL season, Week 7 is underway on EA Sports. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds, so really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Take this one up only to about the 44-yard line. Give him three there on the first play of the game, and it's second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
The last run got three. Now here's second and seven. Now it's Breida. And he'll only get a yard, maybe two, up to the 46.
Jordan Boyer.
Whenever we talk about the best strong safeties, one word constantly comes up, and that's instincts. Being able to diagnose run or pass and make the appropriate moves.
He crashed down hard there. He was ready for that running play. Third play here this opening drive as they're up against a third and five. Now Cousins. They'll set up a screen for Breida. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds.
That's good.
7 yards there. Good enough to move the sticks.
I like the screen being called here early in the game, especially on the opening drive, because, Brandon, when guys come out of the locker room, especially those pass rushers, they are so amped up to get to the quarterback that you can use that against them, and a screen pass is a great way of doing it. A lot of teams against good pass rushing teams, they want to run the screen 10 to 12 times in a game.
And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10.
Second and 10 at the 47-yard line.
This is Breida. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. 16 yards, a first down.
First and 10 at the 31-yard line.
Here's Breida. And he'll be a little shy of the 25 here at the 26-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
At the 26-yard line.
They're trying to jet sweep with Nelson. And he went nowhere. He'll lose yardage back to the 29. It'll be a loss of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up third down. From the gun, here's Cousins, and he's got Kyle Rudolph, and he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 19. Give him 10 yards there as this offense is on a roll. This drive continues to plunge forward. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. The first carry now. This is Williams. And he'll get this one down to about the 17. Credit him with a 1 yard gain there to make it second and 9. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the top rushing defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. And they're going to lose some on this play. Being knocked back to the 18. It's a loss of a yard, so it's back to third and 10.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
It's been a pretty long opening drive. This will be play number 11 coming up on third down. Cousins to throw it this time. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off down near the 5. Defenders giving chase, but I don't think they're going to get
bring
there.
Bring in the second string. Bring in the second
and
string.
And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. A big play there by the rookie. An interception followed by the return for 6 points.
If you want to be accepted by your teammates and coaching staff, make plays like that.
Now Greg Zuerlein on for the extra point. His kick is good to make it 7-0 KC.
Makes the score Chiefs 7, Washington nothing. Greg Zuerlein set to kick off.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick 6. And now the kick is away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
Washington takes over first and 10. At their own 25-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And following the pick 6, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick 6. We'll see how they attack this drive. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And they have possession, and they have it at the 38-yard line. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48. So not quite a first down just yet as they come up on second and less than a yard.
At their 48-yard line.
They will run for the first time with Miles Sanders. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Now look, that wasn't a huge gain, but those are the types of carries I think they were missing in their loss last week. They couldn't get him going on the ground.
Did you get the same feeling I did during our meetings, that they kind of regretted that he didn't touch the
Absolutely.
Ball?
Absolutely.
You know, hey, he should have touched him more last week. They weren't going to make that same mistake. They've taken care of that early.
Flush to his right. And on the catch right side, this is Sanders. And he is out of bounds, but not before he's inside the 30. Nice play for Kansas City, picking up the first 18 yards that time. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Score, Chiefs 7, Washington nothing.
Throwing now, Wilson on first down. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
And plays like that really hurt play calling. They had a really nice gain on the previous play, but gave about half the yardage back on the sack. Excellent pressure up front. Nowhere to go with the football. Down he goes.
After the sack on first down, Wilson. Got an open man. It's Valdez-Scantling. And he'll take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown.
Complete.
Marquez Valdez-Scantling, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Chiefs are able to grow their lead. And a nice job by him to catch the slant and then navigate and break free.
And receivers love slant routes because it gets the ball in their hands so quickly and oftentimes on the move. When they're on the move like that, then they get to use their best asset, which is usually their speed.
And their speed sometimes, like this instance, can take them into the end zone.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. Try and get things settled down a little bit.
4-yard line.
The last run got six, now second and four. To throw, Cousins. Oh, it's a screen pass. That's complete. And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 7 yards there and a first down.
Washington.
On the handoff, this is Breida. And he'll have a gain of three to the 33. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven.
It's a pickup of three.
Play fake, Cousins.
At the 33.
That'll be complete to Breida. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds.
That might feel like a little bit of a lost opportunity there for the offense because the defense brought pressure that time. And sometimes against that, you can get it out to your running back and it could turn into a big gain downfield. But what a nice job they did getting to him quickly and holding him to a short gain.
Washington on third down. They've been okay. 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and four.
Mike, Mike. 65.
Working out of the gun, Cousins. And this is caught by Watkins. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs 43. Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play.
43-yard line.
This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Now a give to Breida. And some good tackling there as he stopped up at about the 41. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down.
It's second and 8.
From the shotgun, it's Cousins. It's brought incomplete. It's John Brown. And he'll be brought down with a first down as the tackle's made at the Chiefs' 25-yard line.
25-yard line.
Gonna give this time to tailback. They'll be brought down at the 21 after a pickup of 4. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6.
A gain of 4. It's now 2nd and 6.
Here's Watkins on the jet sweep. And on this one, he'll get to the 15, right at the 15-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
First and 10 at the 15-yard line.
Minutes to play, first half, it's 14-0.
Come on, fellas.
I will remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
Sometimes you just sit back and marvel at what he can do defensively. Speed, strength, quickness, he's the whole package. And that package just wrapped up the runner for a loss.
Maybe just a slight detour on what's been a strong drive. Here's 2nd and 11. They'll try to throw now. Cousins. They'll try and set up the screen. It's complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. And Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll talk it over here before what will be an important 3rd down. Throwing, Cousins, under pressure, and he'll go down, back at the 26-yard line. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next.
A 43-yard attempt.
Marr able to put this one through, and they will get themselves on the board here at 14-3. So they get 3, certainly hoping for 6 after a 13-play drive.
So you console yourself on defense by saying you did your job, right? If they go 13 plays, you only give up a field goal. You did a nice job there. But here's the other part. 13 plays, you don't force any mistakes. You don't take the ball away. Maybe that's the way they should look at it.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. It was still more than a minute to go in the half. Time to try to mount a drive.
And I would think that they would have to. This is today's NFL. You got to push it whenever you get an opportunity. You can never have enough points with the high-powered offenses that you face. And analytics will tell you, try and score when given the opportunity.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. Gun. Here's Wilson. That's complete to Justin Jefferson.
And he'll be out of bounds, but able to get it up past the 45. The catch and run, good for 18 and a first down. Catch number 100 for his career right there, and it's good enough to keep the chains moving. Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. From the shotgun, Wilson. Escaping the pressure right. And this one caught by Cameron Brain. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. Another nice gain, 16 yards there at a first down again.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
On first down, looking long for his tight end, and this is caught, and he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Russell Wilson with two first half touchdown passes, and the Chiefs add on to their lead.
They have really had their way so far in the first half, but they wanted to continue to build on their lead. They know that no lead is safe in this league, so they decided to try their best to get one more as they headed into the half, and they got it done.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. Taking it about the one. And good coverage there on special teams as he'll get him down shy of the 20.
At their own 19-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. And what do you think goes on here in this situation? If you got the football, you're trailing, you're back in your own territory with just a little time. Do you try something?
You're thinking about jump-starting your team, right? You just mentioned it. They're down. They're trying to get back into the game. But you got to figure, if something goes wrong, you may have put yourself in a spot where you may not be able to come back in the second half. Managing risk is a big decision here.
First and 10 here. You know, if they could just get three out of this, there's something about narrowing it to a two-score game at half that makes it feel like much less of an obstacle. Cousins. He'll get this into the hands of Breida. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. 10 more for him on that one. He's been a busy man. It's a first down. Cousins. And the third interception thrown by Cousins. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And this one will be returned to right around the 38-yard line. So that is three interceptions now in this first half. And you hate to ask the question, but let's be honest. We're thinking about it. Do you need to go in a different direction next series?
Potentially. We know that he's probably not going to be on the Pro Bowl ballot. That's not really his stature here. But he has been their starting quarterback for this game. So they've got to weigh things about who's behind him. Do they think he can snap it back into gear? Maybe change up the play calling to help him out a little bit.
And that is incomplete. He couldn't hold on through the contact. Brings up second down. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there. But it's going to be second down. Sanders. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and nine looming. On third down, Wilson. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 33. And his guys have got it back at the closing stages of the first half.
Over first and 10 at their own 33-yard line.
Behind,
out there set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Following the interception, Cousins. And the Chiefs are going to get him. Shaquille Barrett picks up his second sack of the afternoon. And we're going to get a timeout with 2 seconds remaining in the second quarter. So that complicates things a bit here. 18 yards to go now on second down. Final play of the half, Cousins. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And he will score. Touchdown, Kansas City.
As more and more up-tempo football creeps into the NFL game, some coaches don't think time of possession matters anymore. I believe we found one of them.
Zerline now for the PAT. And they open the lead up now to 25 points.
Makes the score.
So Weaver. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman at REA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. All right, Coach, thank you. And we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. Ready for the start of the third quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. Taken in the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one.
At their own 18-yard line.
Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
On second and 11 now. Wilson firing quickly here, and that's complete.
Wilson's pass.
The reception good for 7. It's third down.
A 7-yard gain on the play. And it's third down.
Quick throw out left. It's complete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. This will be a 2-yard loss on the play. And that'll bring up fourth down. And it is incomplete. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And Washington will take control of the football in great field position.
It's a turnover on down.
On play action, Cousins. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And he is out of bounds right around the 10-yard line. They pick up 11 in addition to moving the chains.
First down and 10 yards to go.
Throwing is Cousins. And the tip there altered the ball flight, and it falls incomplete. It'll be second down.
Well, the passing windows are just not there. That's just another example of how great this defense has been all game long.
And that's exactly what a top 10 defense can do. They can really change the game tempo and frustrate you as you try to execute offensively.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10.
All right, now here we go. Rose, Rose. Check 24, check 24. Safe, safe, safe.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Matt Breida, his third touchdown now on the year. And Washington able to close the gap just a bit. And this is up and good. It cuts the lead to 28-10 now.
Chiefs 28, Washington 10.
Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave him great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down.
Caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain, so now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And that one goes incomplete. He's maybe lucky it wasn't a fumble as he got hit as he threw it.
As defensive coordinators around the league tell me all the time, that throw is not for every quarterback because you've really got to drive the ball downfield. It's going to be a tight window for him to fit that one into. In this case, unsuccessfully.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. From the gun, it's Wilson. And this is going to be incomplete.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts, this time on third down.
Here's Jordan Berry now. And the way this offense has moved the ball, he hasn't been needed till here in the third. Only 2 punts for him last week in the loss as he gets this one away. Good open field tackling there. A 50-yard punt followed by just a 1-yard return. And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. They come in off a touchdown drive the last time they had the ball that cut down that lead. Now the defense has done their part, got them the football back.
Momentum started to shift a little bit when they scored the touchdown. It increased when the defense got them the ball back. Momentum definitely in their favor, and they got to keep things cranking, keep it on high so they can keep cutting into that lead.
Second and 6 at the 33-yard line.
They call that a loss of 6 yards. And it's third down now.
It's now third and 12.
Just do get the playoff. Now Cousins. And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 40. And they will be set up now as he brings this thing all the way back inside the 20. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown 5 picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always just one guy's fault. Maybe somebody ran a wrong pattern. Maybe some balls were tipped. It could be so many different things. Bottom line, though, it comes back to the guy throwing them.
After the interception, here's Wilson. Forced out to his left. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
At the 2-yard line.
Wilson from the gun, he'll throw. Looking in zone, but it's incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there, but it'll be second and goal.
When you run in the slant, timing is everything, and against that man coverage, there was no space available, and incompletion as a result.
On second and goal, Wilson. Being chased out left, and he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Russell Wilson with his third touchdown of the game, number 15 on the year. And the Chiefs use the short field to their advantage as they cash in for six. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
35, Washington 10. Greg Zuerlein set to kick off.
Now after the touchdown, it's Zuerlein. He'll kick it away. And he'll get it up just past the 20 as his guys will go to work at the 21-yard line.
At their own 21-yard line.
Out there set ready for this next drive, the Washington offense.
They are right now just ice cold. I mean, they have struggled big time in this game, and they're getting blown out. How do they adjust?
So tough, because we always talk about it being a team game, and you need all 11 working well together. But every now and then, partner, you need that one guy who can make a play against all odds that maybe can ignite things. And I think that's what they're looking for right now.
Yeah, you talk about going to your playmakers. They probably need to do it.
Find someone that you're used to touching the football that makes big plays and give them that opportunity to maybe wake up everyone else.
Looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game.
Mike, 53. 53. Mike.
All day, dog.
From the gun, here's Cousins. And he's got his man in stride, complete. And he will be marked down short of the first as they get to him at the 29. It'll be a gain of 8, but it'll also lead to a fourth down. Get it to the 33, good enough for a first down. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. Here's a throw out wide complete to his running back right side. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 10 yards there, good for a Washington first down. Now Cousins. It's caught by Quincy Enunwa. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. Well, they had a gain of 10 last time, now a gain of 20 here. Now he's going to swing this one out to his running back. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. Back now at FedEx Field. A lot of folks starting to make their way to the parking lot. Their guys trail big here to begin quarter number 4. This has been a good march down the field, but now they're stuck looking at a second and 14. Again, it's Cousins. That's incomplete. Nearly another pick. My goodness.
That incompletion is not a surprise with the way that this one has gone, and the frustration, the body language is evident everywhere. This team, they've really been put through the ringer in this one.
Hey, check Mike 21. Mike 21. Check Mike 21. I'll get him.
Third and long for Cousins. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off by Jordan Poyer. And the return this time will go out to the 42-yard line.
Well, to be frank, CeeDee, this is getting tough to watch. I mean, you feel for him, but six interceptions, that's at a whole new level. It's not a good level.
It makes it tougher and tougher to come up with ways to try and support him. But you have to as a team because you can't just throw your quarterback aside. You're going to need him later on. But it reminds me of a time that a former defense coordinator of mine told me he was in a game where his quarterback threw seven interceptions. So after the 6-1, one of the defensive players went to the quarterback and said, here's what you do. Throw the ball to the other team, and let's see if our receivers can pick it off and turn it into a completion.
That's just mean. I don't know that I'd go down there and say that to him right now. Probably pretty fragile.
Brings up second and four. At the 37.
6 yards on that last play. Here's second and four.
Double tight. We got three. We got three, fellas. We got three. Check 31. Check. Shoot, shoot, shoot.
On the counter now, it's Sanders. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25. 11 yards there. First down.
At the 26. A gain of 11 on the play.
Now they'll throw it with Wilson. He'll buy some time right. He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown.
Anthony Sherman.
Making a hat trick for Russell Wilson. Three touchdown passes now. And the Chiefs have got it on cruise control. They seemingly just continue to score at will. And as great as it's been for the offense, you got to feel for that defense down there.
And I love how you use the word will, because both teams came into the game with the will to win, but one team has obviously imposed its will on the other and broken them. Because what we're seeing right now, wow, that's a defense that's in tatters after what they faced in this ballgame.
And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21.
21-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll. Well, I think that the folks here had hoped that maybe this home atmosphere would carry their guys to a surprise victory, but it does not appear that that's going to be the case. There's too much to handle on the other side in this one. Oh, he dropped it. And that's pretty indicative of the way this one's gone.
1 yard line.
From the 21, it's second and 10.
This is warm up. Hey, check Mike 21, Mike 21, check Mike 21. All day.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's upended after a gain of four up to the 25-yard line.
He's brought down by
that second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Washington on third down. They've converted three times and eight chances. This will be third and six. He'll get this off to Jamal Williams. Well, this is going to depend on the spot, but it's not a very generous one. He looks to be about a yard or so short.
Five. It's fourth down.
Bang, 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 bang.
Oh, and now movement and a whistle, and they may have to rethink their plans on fourth down. For it here on fourth down. So trailing here in the last quarter. Let's see how this plays out. Working out of the gun, Cousins. And this is incomplete, for it looked like he had it and dropped it. And the Chiefs will have the football back in excellent field position. Now Wilson dancing to his left. He's going to take off with it, and he'll go out of bounds. Browns in the red zone just inside the 20. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
It's a 2nd down run with Sanders. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. Miles Sanders, his 6th touchdown of the season, as his guys continue to put this one out of reach. As that lead just swells and swells. Look, this has been dominance in all 3 phases, offense, defense, and special teams.
So don't we have to give a lot of credit, not just to what we've seen today, but the preparation in advance, coaching staff, commitment by the players to the game plan, and being ready to go in this one? You're exactly right. Clean sweep. And boy, they're going to celebrate this one after it's over.
And on the other side, this is the game film. You just flush and never go back and review.
1st and 10 at their own 20-yard line.
They're set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. They were coming off the extra week of rest, but this team started sluggish, and it really didn't get any better from there, and trailing big here in this 4th quarter.
That one was intended for John Brown, and it's 2nd down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
A 2nd down throw for Cousins. This is complete to Watkins on a slant. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A gain of 13. It's a 1st down. From the shotgun, it's Cousins. Over the middle, he's got Watkins. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45. The catch and run, good for 24 yards.
That's another Washington 1st down. 1st and 10.
On 1st and 10, Cousins. And now here is another interception. Picked off by Micah Hyde. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. Defensively, they've had their way in this one. That pick 6 makes that scoreboard even more lopsided.
I remember talking with a guy in the league, and I said, what do you do when the game's like this? You know, it's pretty much over. You ready to go to the bench and hang out? He said, oh, heck no. I want to stay on the field. I might get some stats. Might get a pick or two.
You like being out there at the end of these wide margins.
When they have to throw it, that gives you more opportunities to go get it.
So they throw the pick 6. They'll get another shot at it now as this one's in the air. Fielded near the back of the end zone, and it'll come out to the 25 as he will not attempt to return.
25-yard line.
The Washington offense at the line and ready to roll.
We certainly had a sense coming in here that these guys were in for a tough one on the road. That has been how this ball game has played out. They trail big as we continue on now here in this 4th quarter.
Back to it after the pick 6. Cousin. And Rudolph has it, the tight end. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down.
2nd and 6.
And to give this time to the tailback. And he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up 3rd down.
3-yard line. It's a gain of 3. Brings up 3rd and 2.
They stay on the ground. Again, it's Breida. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done.
So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back.
They come up on a 4th down situation with things not looking particularly rosy.
It's caught. Nelson. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. No reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. Now a pass dumped off to his running back. And the play goes nowhere, losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. So it goes as a completed pass, but they lose a full 5 yards. And that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass. It's almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
And that will be incomplete. Defensively, you look at the numbers. Another incomplete pass that we just saw, and they're under 200 yards passing for the game, so they've done their job on that side of the ball.
Yeah, recently I was actually working a game where a quarterback had a streak of 5 straight games without a 200-yard game. And that was a big talk, both in his town and amongst his team. How do we get the passing game going? So big credit to them, holding them under 200 today.
A big boot that time, 57 yards the official distance. And the Chiefs are going to take over with a long field ahead and a first and 10. The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And this one has gone pretty well to form. They've come in, had little problem thus far, and now they'll try to polish things off in the fourth. It'll be Sanders to begin the drive. He'll have a first down and more past the 20 as they'll finally stop him at the 23-yard line. First down yardage on the first play of the drive. Give him 14. Right back to Sanders on first down. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. The Chiefs now going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this.
At the 24-yard line.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Wilson wants to throw it. Flushed out right. And he's going to keep it here. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. The rushing numbers for Wilson, maybe down from earlier in his career, but he's still a threat to go, showing it there, picking up the first down. From the shotgun, Wilson. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Second and 10 now, Wilson. Eluding the pressure right. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
Well, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, live to fight another down, right?
And he finds the tight end, Reed. And they'll get him down at about the 37, well short of the first. They get only 4 that time as that leads us to a fourth down.
Today's final score.
Charles, it's one thing to win. It's another thing to win and put up the amount of points that they did. Boy, were they clicking on offense.
They can't help but feel great about themselves, can they? I mean, what a game to put up that number of points, continually feel like they're moving the ball and things are working and clicking. They think that they can bottle this and carry it with them.
As an offensive coordinator, you just don't think you can do anything wrong. Whatever you call, run, pass, it's all going to work.
That's called being in the zone.
So for the Chiefs, their strong start to the year continues as they're up to 5-1. And they'll get another road test next week as they head to Mile High to take on the Broncos.
Meanwhile, for Washington,
they can't quite seem to turn things around as they fall into 2-4 now on the year. And they'll look to regroup next week as they head to MetLife Stadium to take on the New York Giants.
Let me explain what I did. can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a